I think you're secure. Everyone's concentrating on the party. So far, your crazy plan's working.
And Dr. Emerald?
I don't have a fix on her. She's either at the party or at her office at the R&D facility here on the island. I'll scout out the party.
So you're gonna sip champagne while I break into a high-security installation. It's like you got this all figured out.
I'll save you a cocktail, weenie.
Oh, well, in that case...
My cover isn't gonna survive the night, but it'll last a little longer, so you can't walk out the front door with me. This is the quickest way to the R&D facility. I disabled the security at the back door, but there'll be guards. Contact me when you're clear. And Jack, you know what's at stake here. This can't be about revenge.
I'm not here for Paul. Will hurt in the morning.
My powers were growing. I was learning to control them better. That felt good.
There must be some way to open the door. Who the hell designs these doors? Okay, I'm gonna have to move faster to get through. Very sci-fi and very monarch. Something tells me it wasn't commissioned by them, though. Hey, Beth, I'm clear. What's next?
Okay, radar tower up ahead.
All right. You could have warned me about that one, Beth. Okay, how am I getting to that radar? Up you go. Try this again.
Saying to the public.
Hey, it was just our people there. We can spin it however we want. Call it an accident. Or pin it on Joyce.
Yeah, he might as well take the blame for the mess he made.
Time felt broken here. The whole cannon felt unstuck in time. The timeline of the old cannon felt loose. I could shift it around.
Smart place to aim the cannon, guys.
Monarch projections say these stutters are getting more frequent. If one hits while we're grabbing Dr. Amaral...
You'll be frozen. Yeah, I know. It's a risk.
Monarch specialist troopers have the stutterproof gear. I bet Dr. Amaral would have that in her office, too.
I'll keep an eye out. See if I can grab it for you.
I can't believe that Joyce guy just gave himself up like that. That's crazy.
Yeah, well, he's locked up tight now.
He's here somewhere. Go find him.
Leading to the tower. Let me know when you get there.
Thanks, Beth. I need to get to the rear tower. Okay. Next stop, the radar tower. Another one. Beth? I'm at the radar tower. Where's the lab?
Below your feet. It's all top secret. The elevator inside will take you down.
Oh, seriously? What is this, a Bond villain lair?
This is Teresa Sidman.
You have no idea. Just don't fall into the shark tank.
Fuck.
It's a momentous occasion. For years we have been building towards this day. Years of planning, developing, training. For me personally, this marks the end of a 17-year journey. And
speech
today
is streaming.
We emerge from the shadows.
Let's give Monarch the audience they deserve.
We do so accepting great responsibility. I present to you the CFR.
The Cronon Field Regulator. This device has been at the heart of our Cronon research since 2010.
Beth, I'm about to take the elevator. I see Paul's still fond of his own voice.
Yeah, he's talking about his survival plan. Crowd's eating it up. Jack, the whole security network just lit up. They know you're there.
No shit! Move in!
Jesus. The device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a Cronon dampener.
Serene ordered Hatch to kill me because he didn't want to put his plan at risk. But seeing the scale of that facility, I started realizing just how deep that plant went. Made me wonder. If time was ending, what was it all for? Amon's office. Guessing this isn't the usual employee route. Dr. Amaral's office must be close. No alarms. Looks like nobody here knows about the mess I made on the way in. Nice job, Beth. That's Emma's office.
Amaral had tried to warn Paul. The end of time was approaching quickly. Less than 24 hours away.
Mr. Serene believed it would take years to run its course. Admittedly, he was wrong.
That there looks like what Beth wanted. Oh, shit. Amaral's at the park. This stutter won't last. I better find a way out of here and get to the party.
Quite expensive piece of tech you stole.
Bill me. I knew Beth's cover wouldn't last long. Had to get it to her at the party before it was too late. Garage. Sounds like the way out of this place. All I had to do was make it through the garage. Seems simple enough.
What are they gonna do to that Burke guy?
After what he pulled, you gotta figure it out. Yeah, right.
Joyce has escaped custody and is now present at the R&D facility garage. Repeat, Jack Joyce has escaped custody. He is to be neutralized at all cost.
Man down! Cavalry!
Thanks for the heads up.
Go! Now!
Thank you. That alarm's not gonna make my life any easier. There's gotta be a way out of here. Beth, I got that device for you, but Dr. Amaral's at the party.
Yeah, I just spotted her. Wanna be my date?
Yeah, save me that cocktail, weenie. I'll make my way there.
Serene's finished his speech, and he knows you're loose. He's headed your way. Remember what we said. I'll keep the monarch tight, but push the monarch for you to make sure you stay out of here.
Beth, I've got company.
Shotgun advancing!
Great.
Go check it out! That's the last of them.
Good evening, Riverport. It's Teresa here again.
We need the exact coordinates for Joyce ASAP. Monarch Actual is moving into intercept.
This is Hulk. Part 5. Just spotted him entering the tunnel system outside the party grounds.
Huh. Again.
I could see the mansion where the gala was. I had to find a way to get there. I could see the energy field of another Monarch Chronon dampener. It would drain my powers. I'd have to find a way to shut it off.
My powers won't work within that sphere. I better be careful. Security's tough.
can't reach him!
Yeah, now we're talking.
You were headed for the party. What was your plan?
I needed to get to Dr. Amaral before the stutter ended and Monarch found out I was coming.
Should be here somewhere. Need to get to her before the stutter ends.
Mr. Serene's speech had been a success.
The world was falling apart, but the wine and cheese crowd was enjoying their little goddamn soiree. I've been shooting up half a puzzle amusement park.
Yeah, well, Monarch does. I don't think my cover's gonna last.
Yeah, well, I don't think it would do much good for the next part anyway.
Okay, Dr. Amaral's somewhere inside the mansion. Let's go grab her. Bit of luck, we can be gone before anybody notices.
Okay, lead the way. What's our plan once we grab her?
There's a boat dock right outside the mansion.
Okay, we can make that work.
Shit! Drone!
It's in the wrong place at the wrong time, literally.
Jack, Dr. Amaral's in there. We need to get her out before time kicks back in. Shouldn't wait. Let's go get Dr. Am. Jack, get her moving before time kicks back in and that drone turns us into paste.
Let's get to it, Doctor. No, but you're coming with us. We need your expertise.
No.
I'm not asking.
It's collapsing!
Come on, move!
Where's the damn boat?
It's right there.
Okay, go! Get her on the boat, I'll keep you.
Come on,
go, go, hurry up!
You'll never get away with this!
Shit!
Get in!
Joyce! Somehow we got right past us! Don't let them escape! Somebody call them spring!
Jack! They're closing the gate! We'll be sitting ducks here unless you get it open
for us.
Okay, kid! You get going the second you can, okay? Open that gate.
That gate's still closed. What's up?
Yeah, I'm still working on it. Hang tight.
What about you?
You're clear. Go.
I can swing by.
Go.
And...
No. Just go. We went to all this trouble to grab her. Beth, I'm counting on you to keep her alive. Make my own way out.
My plan was simple. There's a bridge to the mainland. I'd fight my way through anything Monarch could throw at me and steal a car, drive it back to the swimming pool.
Just remember, we need your ass alive for the next part.
We'll see how it shakes out.
Thank you.
With Beth and Dr. Amaral clear, it was time for me to get gone. For that, I needed wheels. Valet parking.
This thing growing inside me. I've been fighting it for 6 hard years. Dr. Amaral was developing a cure for the Cronon syndrome. She was the only one who could administer the treatments that kept my sickness at bay.
Paul?
And Jack had taken her away from me.
Morton, how is it possible they managed to take her?
Paul, this is your illness talking. I'm on your side. Easy, you're...
They took her. Without Sophia, there's no chance of a cure.
We did all we could. But there are forces within Monarch working against you, and I believe Burke was just the tip of the iceberg. It wasn't just Joyce that did this.
Sir? We've recovered Dr. Amaral's laptop. We have it set up over there if you want to take a look.
I'll be right there. I want to go over Sophia's figures. If she's right, the fracture is escalating a lot faster than we anticipated.
You know the future. Dr. Amaral doesn't. Is the lifeboat even in a viable state for activation? She's trying to convince you the schedule's wrong. Why? To get you to rush this? To make a mistake? The people opposing you. She could be one of them.
She isn't.
Are you willing to bet the entire plan on that? I implore you, hold off on activation, Paul. Let me clean house before this gets completely out of hand. How do you want to proceed?
Somebody was working against me. Somebody close. Martin Hatch. Sophia Amaral. I could only trust one of them.
I want him apprehended. Immediately.
Sir, I have some information about Martin Hatch.
Martin had been my closest advisor for years. I began to wonder if that had been a mistake.
Sophia's loyal. She's always been loyal.
I don't think we can trust her. The way she looked at the countermeasure like she's seen it before. She knows what it does.
Sophia's research had saved my life. Loyalty doesn't run any deeper. Sophia's data's always been good. I'll trust your judgment. We need to analyze these figures and make final preparations to activate the lifeboat protocol at once.
Fine. I'll take the laptop to the science department.
No, I think I'll do that myself.
I see.
Sir?
Put people on Mr. Hatch. I want constant eyes on him.
Yes, sir. You got it. We pulled some images from the security cameras. We've identified Joyce's accomplice. She's Beth Wilder, one of our mid-level operatives.
Her. My God, she's been with us all along. She's working with Jack. Where is she now?
Unknown. But we've got a kill team tracking her.
No. She can't be killed. Not yet. Find her. And whatever Mr. Hatch does, I want to know about it. Don't screw this up. Beth Wilder. It was the first time I'd heard her name, but she had been there in the past. When it all started, she'd been here the whole time, working against me from the inside. And she wasn't the only one.
You took the one thing Mr. Serene needed to survive, Dr. Amaral. That made you priority one.
Yeah, they made that clear. Monarch lined every escape route with barricades, roadblocks. I had to get to the mainland, but I couldn't do it by car. Needed a new plan.
All right, let's go.
Beth, I think I'm gonna need a ride. The streets are too hot.
All right, where do you want me?